Herkese merhabalar Kutsal Motor'a. Hoş geldiniz. Ben Kaan. Tek başımayım ama hayırlı bir sebeple bugün webcam karşısına geçtim. Nedir bu hayırlı sebep? Biliyorsunuz ki Netflix'te önümüzdeki günlerde önemli bir film vizyona giriyor. Malcolm and Marie, epeydir beklenen, merak edilen, pandemi döneminde çekilmiş bir ilişki filmi. Ben de buradan filmin oyuncuları ve yönetmeni Sam Levinson'la kısa bir söyleşi gerçekleştirmek üzere yerime kuruldum. Aramalarını bekliyorum. Herkese de keyifli seyirler diliyorum.
Malcolm, I haven't eaten all night.
That's not what this is.
Malcolm, it's 1 in the morning. Can we just eat and go to sleep?
Please, Marie, I really don't want to fight tonight.
Neither do I. That is why I'm making you mac and cheese.
So you are angry?
No.
Was it the thing that Anthony said?
No.
The joke about you being a model?
No.
Wouldn't take it seriously. He's older from a totally different era.
I didn't take it personally.
Promise.
Promise.
Was it Taylor?
No.
You sure?
Yes.
Because I know how you get weird around Taylor.
I do not get weird around Taylor.
You get meek.
Meek? Huh, really?
Hello. Nice to see you, John David.
Hello, hello. Good to see you.
I'm starting with my questions. So when I think about the characters in the film, I mean, how they move, how they talk, how they engage with each other, to me, it felt like both choreographed and spontaneous at the same time. So was this one of your main goals artistically? And as the actors, how did you achieve the balance between Malcolm and Marie?
I'd say that's an accurate description of what we did. It was, we were embracing naturalism and sort of the messy movement, even in the words. There's a lot of, you know, words I had to look up in the dictionary, but there's a lot of curse words as well. So we want to make it as lived in as possible. So the trick for that is having spots to land on, maybe, but how you get to those spots is up to you. You know, and that's really a difficult task for Marcel, our DP. He nailed it. He was able to capture our rhythms so beautifully and seamlessly. And, you know, we didn't really have marks, but there was sections we were trying to get to in certain instances where we were talking. However, like there's this huge rant that Malcolm goes on outside in the tree. All that was just free for all. They said, because it was working better when I was just not knowing where I was going. The words were taking me where I was supposed to go, and they captured it. So it was a combination of both, but it was fun to figure that out and block that, but yet kind of don't worry about the blocking at the same time. It was kind of fun to do that.
Thank you. So the character you're embodying, Malcolm, is a young, promising and ambitious filmmaker. He's maybe too ambitious, and therefore his ego is very fragile. And this male ego thing and its vulnerability is one of the central subjects in the film. So what would you say about his core characteristics? And if you may be a friend of Malcolm, if you were a friend of Malcolm, how would you counsel, what would you suggest him?
Good question. I think he's a very passionate individual. I think he has an encyclopedia-like knowledge of film. I think he really loves it. You know, it's very personal to him. And I think maybe too personal. And he could lose his voice and identity because he's chasing these giants, these ghosts of filmmakers, you know, whether it be the Battle of Algiers or you know, Cassavetes films, William Wyler, William Wyler films. I think that could get in his way. So I would tell him as a friend, find your own voice. The experiences that you have, you should do that. You should lean into that. He says in one of the rants, like he does, I think he understands that too, but he gets in his own way. He said, two shot, film or digital, it doesn't matter. And you know, maybe for him, it shouldn't because he knows all this stuff and he thinks what works is what's going to work. But you got to find your own voice. And I think we're seeing them on that night trying to find that.
Okay. Thank you. That's all for me.
Oh, great questions. Thank you.
You getting clean was a part of the inspiration.
At 20.
Yes, and you were able to provide genuine insight into that, what that was like. But your mind is not based on you. It's an amalgamation of a whole different thing, a whole bunch of things.
Who?
People.
What people?
A lot of different people. Mm. Like my cousin.
Okay.
Rick, for one. You know, it's a lot of different cousin. People, a lot of different things.
You know what, Malcolm? feel like once you know someone is there for you and once you know they love you, you never actually think of them again.
That's not true.
It's until you're about to lose someone that you finally pay attention.
Is that what this is?
What?
Is what you're threatening. If I don't apologize, I'm going to lose you?
I'm not looking for an apology, Malcolm.
Well, what do you want, a screenplay credit?
Don't be cruel.
So to start with, I want to ask that, how personal is the film and what was the main drive for you to tell this story?
You know, it's funny, the film is not that personal in the larger sense of it, in terms of what happens within the movie itself. I think the idea of forgetting to thank someone is something that I've done before. And I think those conversations and the guilt and the anxiety of what happens when you don't acknowledge, you know, someone's contributions to your work, to your life as a partner, as a loved one, is something that I've thought a lot about. When I forgot to thank my partner, we had a very mellow conversation about it on the car ride home, and it never turned into a big fight. But I liked it as an inciting incident to kind of explore the dynamics of this fictional relationship.
Thank you. So this one is for you, Zendaya. The film takes place in one location and also in one night, of course. But on the other hand, Marie is carrying a heavy past, which is constantly biting her. So how would you describe the process of embodying such an enigmatic character?
You know, it's interesting because it's different from anything I've experienced in the sense that, like, the character, it wasn't like written on paper and then given to me, and then I just had to find my way into the character. Marie was not only written for me, but I think in a lot of ways, Sam wrote her to me, meaning to the woman that I am becoming, and he is watching kind of grow into my own. So with there being a lot of myself in Marie, there's also a lot of Sam and Marie, but there's also a lot of just none of us in Marie too. So it's this interesting kind of relationship, trying to figure out and mold who she is. But with that being said, because we were all doing this together, I kind of got to be a part of every step of the way as she was being formed and created, and have an influence in what kind of person she is and what kind of person Malcolm is. Cause I think there's parts of us in Malcolm too, you know, we can't lie about that either, you know? So it was special because of that, I just felt like she just kind of found her way into me instead of me having to find my way into her. And with that being said, when we actually got there and got in the space, you know, there was even then more things that I was uncovering and discovering about who she was, and how she moves, because we were able to shoot it in order. So as we were shooting in order, the energy kind of changes. And now that I'm with John David and I'm able to do the scenes with him, you know, now this energy and this incredible performance that he's giving me, now I have something to feed off of, and it affects then how I respond, you know? So I was trying to be as present in Marie as I could as well, because I wanted to just kind of live life through her eyes and in her a little bit. So with that being said, I think it was very different than anything I've ever experienced. And I just kind of got to just fall into her in a way that was different. Like, I never felt like I was searching too far, right? It always felt like for some reason she was just right there. And I just kind of got to use her honestly as a vessel to let a lot of things out.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you for your answers. It was very nice to see you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.